most people are aware that if you cut a tree down, you can see the rings in it, and that those rings tell you how many years the tree grew for. What is less widely known is that the pattern of those rings is a tool that we can use to both identify where and when the tree grew. Each individual tree has its own pattern that is reflecting things that happened to that individual tree in its lifetime, and trees within regions and areas have similar patterns in such a way that we can use them as a tool to both locate in an approximate sense where trees come from and very precisely when they were growing. When we date a board, we date the last ring that is present in the board, and we have to make certain estimates or assumptions about the way the trees are converted into boards and how much loss there is along the way in order to turn those into useful dates for our historical purposes. One of the key differences between these two portraits is that this one is made from oak derived from the Eastern Baltic, and this one is made from oak derived from somewhere in England. The grain on these is very tight and very, very straight, and the grain on this one, you can see, is much more open and much more skewed. This is from a much more branched or twisted tree, and because it's a twisted tree, it's more likely to distort over time. This is a single board panel. There are no joints in this. And the last ring on this board is down in this corner and is 1527. There is no sapwood visible on this edge, so we know this has been trimmed of the outer rings. We have to allow the minimum amount of sapwood missing. In this case, we would use an estimate of a minimum of 10 for English material. So it is later than 1537, which, since it's a portrait of Edward when he's relatively young, means it's in period. The tree ring data for this suggests this is from London, Surrey, Hampshire kind of area. It's about 10 millimetres thick, which is very normal. The material is used in green form. There was no concept of seasoning in the 16th century. The tool marks on them, and indeed the warping on them, would be much less severe if they had been let dry properly before they were used. So there's plenty of reasons to suppose that there is a production line of this stuff coming in from the woodlands, coming in off the ports, and being turned into panels and being turned into paintings in a relatively short order.